Good evening, everyone. This is Kobus Minnar speaking. I am making this video to inform you about an upcoming course on feedlotting. Feedlotting in the sense of not just cattle, also including sheep and small stock, and also intensive feeding of breeding stock in times of high nutrient demand. Like pregnancy and lactation, creep feeding, those kind of areas. So the course, I'll just run through the course content with you. I just want to share my screen. Okay, so the course is divided up into four topics, including feeding, the selection of the right type of livestock for your feedlot, the health and diseases that you can encounter in an intensive feeding system, and then your feedlot design, space and so on, requirements. You can either pay for the whole course, or you can pay it in smaller amounts spread over a period of time, just paying per topic. I'd like to cover the topic contents with you. So the first topic is feeding, and we're looking at ruminant digestion and so on, the parts and the functions of the different parts in the digestive system. We're going to cover all the nutrients that is in feed. We're going to look at the digestibility of feed and how it's measured and expressed. We're also going to do the same for energy, how and where and when it's digested and extracted. Then we're going to look at the importance of roughage and the ways of making it more digestible, including and also preservation then of it through ammonification, making of hay, silage and baleage. We are also going to look at the energy sources, the ingredients that will go into making a feedlot ration. And with the aim of doing a basic ration balancing for ourselves at the end of the course. So we'll give you all the information, all the requirements, nutrient requirements of the animals, the nutrients that's available in different feed sources, and then we're going to put it together in a ration balancing at the end. So energy sources, protein sources, minerals, and so on, and then we're going to look at the nutrient requirement for our small stock during different stages of reproduction, and of course for growth rate if you're fattening them for slaughter, and then also the same for cattle, and then we're going to put it together in a balanced ration. We're going to look at how to adapt stock that came off the felt to the feedlot. Otherwise, if you just start feeding concentrates, the next day they die dead from acidosis or bloat. We're going to look at feed block making and whether it's mineral, drought or protein leaks and or energy leaks and so on. So we're going to do that as well. Sorry. Then we're going to look at the selection of livestock. Sort of what ages, what's the advantage of different selecting different ages, the carcass conformation, the fat covering and the sex, and of course all of those make up your grading system. So we're going to look at the Botswana one, but of course most grading systems in the world work on age firstly, then carcass conformation, then fat covering and then sex. And so on. So we'll go through those. Then we're going to look at what type of stock to breed, different breeds, different cross breeds and so on, the influence of age and sex and so on to get the stock that will perform best in your feedlot. We're also going to look at the management, how to weigh them, how to record keeping, scanning for pregnant stock and so on, and the timing to market, what time of year you're going to get the best price, branding your product for people to start knowing that this brand provides soft, juicy, young beef and not shoe leather like you get in most restaurants in Botswana at the moment. Then we're going to look at health, the aspects that things that you are more likely to get into in an intensive feeding system, and it also poisoning and parasite control, internal and external. Then we're going to look at the design of a feedlot. It's from fencing, the size and shape of the pens, the size and shape and space requirements for feeding troughs. Shade orientation, very important. The water quality and the volumes required. The handling facilities to work with the animals to effectively control and draft them and so on. Then we're going to look at equipment needed and also feed storage and handling requirements for a feedlot. Then last but not least, manure handling. If you put a lot of animals together in a small space, then you've got a lot of buildup of manure. You can see that as a problem or a resource, but in either case, you've got to remove it from the pens at a regular interval and then do something with it, either compost it, produce biogas or whatever. Now the format of the course, guys, is once a week, we have a live lecture like this, something like this. It will look sort of the same. We do it on Google Meet. Once you enroll, you get a link. The links are posted on Google Classroom, and you click on the link at 8 o'clock on a Wednesday. Most probably, this will be 8 o'clock in the evening, 8 till 9. You watch the live recording for an hour about that week's topic. So if this was week 17, this is the topic that we would cover that during that week. The Sunday before the Wednesday, you will get some preparation work, which might be videos to watch about this topic, or reading or vocabulary. And as soon as the live lecture is finished, there will be a little assignment, which will most probably be a multiple choice type assignment, and it's more there to tell you what was the important bits that you need to remember in the week before. So every week we have that same format, some preparation work, the live lecture, and an assignment that goes with it. So not very time consuming. But it's a comprehensive feedlotting system where at the end you can produce basic rations for yourself. You'll know the nitty-gritty, you'll know how the engine works, and you'll be able to do this confidently. So guys, yeah, we're looking at forward to seeing you. There'll be a link to get to the training course, and for enrollment, basically we have you pay your money, you email the proof of payment to that email address. Please supply your name. We often get people paying and then we don't know who's paid. So supply your name and also your country. We've got this course is running right through Africa. So please tell us where you're from, and we can sort of tailor make it if it's where possible. And also your Gmail address and so on, so we can send you information and updates and so on. So the course you can either pay upfront, which will give you a bit of discount, or you can spread it out over a longer period of time and make it more affordable that way. So guys, love to see you on the course. We call ourselves Training for Farmers, and this is our new feedlotting course starting in a few weeks' time. So looking forward to seeing you, and please enroll, and if you need more information, use that same email address to inquire. Thanks very much. Have a great week and see you soon.